certainly bring it up again. All right, so we call the meeting to order for May 22nd. The first order of business is approval of the May 15th minutes. I think we're gonna have to table that because, I mean, if you want to, I would assume you'd want to abstain from that one.
I will.
So we will table. Is there community input this evening? Yes?
Yeah, I got a question on the Pinch Hill. Was that culvert the one that was gonna be put in later, that got put in by the T? It was a...
I don't know. Suzanne was going to ask the question. I don't know if she did.
What culvert's that?
The one on Pinch Hill.
On Pinch Hill.
The culverts that are there now.
Yeah, but wasn't one that we were gonna, they were gonna hold off on until later?
Across from the Jalbert's property.
Across from the Jalbert's, yeah, we didn't put that one in.
We didn't do it.
No, they're talking about the one by the T that's a driveway culvert now.
Yeah, yeah, the farm, when we dug that one out, the farmer, I forget his name, Phil, actually wanted it. So he asked us to put it up on the property. He was gonna use it someplace else on the farm. We were gonna haul it off. Is that what you're talking about?
No, you put in a culvert.
There is a culvert there.
Or a driveway.
Yeah, we put a culvert in. There's one, we actually put one culvert in on Pinch Hill. And that's the one that they use to enter the field by the, where they store their manure.
Okay.
So, any other...
So we put in a driveway culvert?
We did, and that was part of the bid.
That was part of the plan all along. There wasn't an additional one that we met about.
Yes.
Well, my question is that first good frost heave and that thing's gonna heave right out of the ground because it's not very deep.
It's got 12 inches of cover on it.
Okay.
Any other questions or comments this evening? Seeing none, we're gonna get on to department head business. First, the building inspector, he is not here this evening, but he is monitoring the activity on Church/Washington Street that was brought to our attention. I've also been by, it looks like they are just removing debris from the building, but we are monitoring it. 39 Rollins Road, Mr. Clark has reviewed it, and they do indeed need a building permit. I didn't notice if there's one in there or not. It was a driveway paving. Minimum housing standards ordinance is tabled until Suzanne arrives. I'm working off the wrong agenda, I apologize. Until she comes back. Health inspector's not here, and we don't have anything for him. I think bed bugs are still on the agenda, but it's not on the, it's haven't made it onto the printed agenda. Fire department doesn't seem to be here this evening. Highway department.
Does PD want to go before?
Do you have a non-public that you want to do?
I do have a non-public.
Would you like to go, Chief?
I can, but
unless you have one too.
I do, actually. Continuation from last week.
All right, we'll just go down for the board.
That's fine.
Okay, so the highway department, the only thing that you have, do you have anything else for us?
I have a couple purchase orders.
All right, why don't you bring them forward and we'll...
Yeah, it's gonna be purchase order 955 to Pike Industries. I'm looking to haul some gravel into Bicentennial Park. I like to do every year, it's for the sum of $350. I'm just gonna add my gravel account, which is plenty of money here.
Purchase order 955 Pike for gravel, for gravel. Bicentennial Park for $350.
Second. So this is the yearly...
Yeah, just to kind of maintain.
The beginning part of the, we don't maintain it.
We don't maintain it. We just haul it in and...
One of the residents who lives on that road actually maintains it. The longstanding arrangement for the town. Any other discussion on purchase order 955? Seeing none, all those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Passes unanimously. What else you got for us, Jeff?
Purchase order 954 to the city of Dover, and it was worked on, it was done on the 7123.
Move to accept purchase order 954 to city of Dover for $71.23. Any questions?
Work done on the five. Okay, so work there. So second.
So what?
We had electrical issues this one day.
Okay.
But the sand part of it was short out, so.
Okay.
They were able to, it was there.
But you were able to, like, this didn't just happen?
No, this was back like January. We just received the bill.
Okay.
It was coming out of vehicle maintenance?
Yes.
Any other questions on purchase order number 954? Seeing none, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? All right, thank you. What else you got for us, Jeff?
It's 953 to air gas, and it's for our yearly renewal of our cylinders, our oxygen, acetylene, and our argon, for $165.
Move to accept purchase order 953 to air gas for renewal of contract for one argon tank, one acetylene tank?
Acetylene.
Acetylene.
Thank you, and one oxygen tank for $165.
Second, I only know that because of welding, right? Okay, any other questions or comments on purchase order number 953? Seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, those opposed?
And last one, ACE 952 to Fastenal for the sum of $69.19, and it's for bolts and nuts for the plow that was, had damage done to it this winter.
Move to accept purchase order 952 to Fastenal for bolts for the plow for $69.19.
Second, this is for the plow that we were rebuilding?
Yes.
Okay. Perfect, okay. Any other questions or comments on purchase order number 952?
No.
All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, opposed? All right, passed unanimously. Do you have anything else for us, Jeff?
That's it.
How are we progressing on, do I go, or?
No.
How are we progressing on Foundry and Pinch Hill?
Foundry Street has a binder down. They're coming back Wednesday to start raising the structures and start to form a swale. Pinch Hill has the binder down. Intersection has been reconfigured. We're scheduled for top June 1st and June 2nd. That's the paved top. And the project will be complete shortly after that.
And transfer station?
Still working on dates on that.
Okay.
It's more to do with the wall than anything.
Right.
Because they have to, I told them like the week we were shut down, like that's one that has to be done. So they're trying to coordinate and get everything, and the wall and everything.
But it's moving along?
Yes.
Great.
Anything else for us before we go into non-public?
Nope.
Is it a personnel issue?
It is.
Okay, I'll move that we go into actually, you probably should do it.
No, you always do it.
Aye.
Doesn't matter.
I do that, but.
Yeah.
Okay, move to go into non-public personnel issue.
Second. Those in favor, Jody?
Aye.
Mike, aye, we are non-public session for personnel issue.
Some kind of plan.
656.
Fourth floor.
One night, you know, it's sort of sunny there. The time was going fast, but it didn't really move that fast. Okay, so anything else for the highway department?
So I'll just go plus five.
There you go.
I'm good, does the board have anything?
No, I think we're good, thank you, have a great night.
Thank you.
The police department is up.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Couple of purchase orders. First one is number 1204. To reimburse myself out of our postage line item number 230. Last week I purchased two rolls of stamps, we could send out the Silver Street, Silver Lane residential survey. So it was actually a double stamp because we sent them a self-addressed stamp, that will have to return the surveys to us, so. $98.
Move to accept purchase order 1204 for Robert Ducharme for $98 for stamp, for 200 stamps.
Second. Any discussion on purchase order number 1204? Seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, those opposed? Passed unanimously. What else we got?
Okay, purchase order number 1205, made out to Rogers Auto Body, the cruiser number 74, which is the 2014 Ford Explorer. Both the front doors, the vinyl covering is pulling away from the top part where the window goes down into the well. So they seem to re-glue it. So that's $240, that's line item 707, on vehicle repairs.
Move to accept purchase order 1205 to Rogers Auto Body for auto repair of interior windows for $240.
Second. Any discussion on purchase order number 1205? Seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, opposed? Passed unanimously.
Purchase order number 1207, we have a two-way communications, line item of 287, radio repair account. We've got two blue lights that are on the Cruiser 72, which is a 2010 Ford Explorer that are out. I salvaged two blue lights from upstairs that we had from a prior vehicle, so we're just gonna swap them out. And we're gonna change laptop mounts from the 72 and put that in the new car, the 71. So I estimate that's gonna be no more than $200, and that'll be, again, line item of 287, radio repair.
Right.
Move to accept purchase order 1207 to two-way communication for multiple repairs, radios, for $200.
Second. Any discussion of purchase order 1207? If not, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, opposed, none. All right.
Okay, the last item, last summer, we applied to get a grant from Homeland Security for two laptops, two monitors, and the printer for the EOC downstairs. That was approved last fall, but we finally decided that now's the time to go and purchase the items. So I got purchase number 1206, made out of Staples, and it's to come out of town reimbursement account. Two Dell laptop computers, $359.99 each, for a total of $719.98, two 27-inch LED monitors for $299.98 total, and one HP Office Jet Pro printer for $129.99, for a total amount of $1,149.95. Of that, we received from Homeland Security the entire amount, $1,149.95, because our matching part was participating in the exercise that we did last year for Homeland Security.
Move to accept purchase order 1206 to Staples for two Dell laptop computers, two LED monitors, one printer for a total of $1,149.95.
Second. Any discussion of purchase order number 1206? Seeing none, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, opposed, none. All right.
That's all that I have for the public portion, unless you have something for me.
I do. The truck on South Street seems to have not moved in the last few weeks.
It has not. I noticed it there again today. We have gone to that house at least probably half a dozen times, trying to arouse somebody, and every time, no one's answering the door.
Okay.
So I think our next step is to actually put a letter on the windshield saying, move it or lose it. Type of thing, so
okay.
We'll take care of that tomorrow.
Works for me. So, anything else for the public portion of the meeting?
Oh, I want to thank you for the donation to the rec department.
You're welcome. All right, if there isn't anything else for the public portion,
motion to go into non-public for personnel issues.
Personnel issues, yes.
Motion to go into non-public for personnel issues.
Second. Jody?
Aye.
Aye. We are in non-public session for personnel issues.
So it's
7:11. Oh yeah, wait for the
it's
record 7:10. Keeper to
come
in. Sorry.
7:10. According to my computer.
That's all that I have for you folks. Anything for me?
No. Right, sure. All right, thank you.
Have a good night.
Have a good night.
All right, I believe I saw the fire department coming.
You did.
Yes, you did.
Come on up, Chief. Sorry.
Come on up, Kayla. No, I'm sorry. I had no non-public stuff.
Oh, shucks.
You know, when I got the trifecta tonight?
I already asked him.
I think we're very happy about that. Thank you. We appreciate it.
Well, in 5 years, I haven't had to go that route. I have one purchase order, and it kind of concerns the young woman sitting next to me. I don't know if you know her. This is Kayla Reno.
Mm-hmm.
Her father was on the fire department. She bring her back a long, long time ago. But the reason why Kayla's here tonight is... She completed her emergency medical technician advanced class.
Awesome. Congratulations.
So that's like the next step. Now her next step would be paramedic if that's what she wishes to pursue.
That's outstanding.
And she's also a member of York Ambulance now. She's
okay.
Been employed there, how long? A couple of months now?
That's
great.
So we have someone from our staff on their staff.
Exactly.
That's a good thing.
It is a very
thank
good
you
thing.
For that too. Congratulations.
Yeah, it's a very good thing. Because when I you know, need to get something or talk to Brian over there. I can kind of run it through Kayla because I know she's going to see him on a regular basis sometimes. I see him an awful lot anyway. Mm-hmm. But the reason why I have her here is one thing that we do with the fire department, when she took her training, we reimburse them for half of it once they show
right.
that they got the certificate. So I have purchase order number 1137, and it is to reimburse it for Kayla Reno for her completion on her advanced EMT. I just wanted to bring her in so you could see.
We would have done it either, even if you weren't here.
At least a member, again, I've seen a member of the fire department.
Nice of you to come in, thank you.
Thank you. Mike, do you have a picture? We can put it on Facebook.
We can take a picture.
I didn't bring my camera.
Well, there's other pictures in here from some of the other guys.
Someone will take a picture, we'll put it on if you want.
Move to exempt purchase.
It's a big achievement. I don't know how many hours it is, but it's an enormous amount of hours in the level that she's achieved.
Sure is.
And now she put her skills to work on both sides, both with the fire department and the EMS.
I have that mind.
Because you're a candidate.
I think all of you guys.
We will be, yeah, let's pay her first, so then we'll do it outside.
All right.
Move to exempt purchase order 1137 to Kayla Reno for reimbursement for advanced EMT, $600.
Second. Is there any discussion of purchase order 1137? If not, all those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed? That's unanimous, congratulations, Kayla. And you sign this first, and I think maybe we'll move to it. Always nice to be able to honor one of our.
Keeping it.
One of our public.
Trying to expand on that a little bit, starting tomorrow night. You want to have the certificate?
Yeah.
We'll have the chief handing our certificate, how's that? We'll stand on either side, how's that?
Hey, let's get a picture of that.
There you go.
All right, let's.
Go right ahead.
I don't want something after time, right? You could have warned us, I wouldn't have worn a sweatshirt and jeans.
Jeans.
We thought it'd be a quick meeting tonight, but we need to, because they're coming up.
From the middle up.
Exactly.
Totally good.
You hand her a certificate, you stand in the middle, give her a certificate, we'll stand on either side, how's that?
There you go, Kayla. You go, you hold someone tight, I'll hold the other side.
Here.
Congratulations. Thank you for doing that. Appreciate it.
Well, Kayla's one of our studious and one of our more dependable employees here, so.
How long have you been in the fire department, Kayla?
2010. I started as an explorer.
Oh, even better. That's great.
Yep, she's worked her way up through.
Well, it's great that that program has brought in a number of people that have decided to stay, right? That's great.
It's been a great feeder to us, and she was a Somersworth student, she went through the level one CTC class that I instruct, so she was a member of that. That's where she got her initial firefighter one certification.
And you still stayed even though.
Yeah. They do something right every now and then.
Every now and then, right?
Every now and then. And just to expand on that a little bit more, starting tomorrow night, Kayla, again, doing more training to benefit the fire department. Herself and two other members are gonna be going to North Berwick to take an EVOC class, which is Emergency Vehicle Operator Course. We already have, there was a picture here, I think we did like a year and a half ago with some of the other members. But we want more drivers. This is a preparation of when the new fire truck arrives at the end of the year. Kayla's been driving an awful lot of the equipment now, but I wanted to do that certification, so that's right. She'll be all ready to go. So if you see a fire trucks running around, that's what they're doing, they're getting their driver.
I'm gonna ask you a question about that in a moment, but.
So they can go do that. Question on that in a moment? Go ahead.
Whenever you're done.
Go right ahead, ask me what you got.
So South Berwick was here on Sunday, doing something at the public boat launch over.
They go and do pump training.
Is that what they're?
Flow some water. That's the best access for any of the fire departments already. You even see Somersworth there all that time doing it. Because you can get right to it, it's easy access. But they'll do that for training of their personnel, whether it be recertification or new guys doing it or whatnot. So if you went by there, you saw them, probably what they were doing, throwing water back in the river, right?
It looked like it. I mean, I didn't have an issue with that, just if people ask me, you know, why is the South Berwick Fire Department doing something there?
Yes.
Give them an answer.
Just easy access for them to train the spot.
Perfect.
And the other reason why they do a lot of, we do have a large incident in town somewhere. Our water supply in the community is marginal at best. If we had a large incident downtown or flowing massive amount of water, one of our contingency plans to that for the supporting of a fire incident is somebody at the boat ramp pumping water back uptown so we can have another source. Because if we had to flow for hours and hours and hours, we'd drain the water in the tank.
Right.
The town system is not enough to keep up. So that's one of our contingencies. And guess who's gonna be there if it happens?
That Berwick, hopefully. Fair enough.
They know. So that's part of their training regimen too. So, and the other thing that I wanted to bring up with you is just kind of an update on what's going on with the new fire truck. We finalized the stats, the specs on it about a week ago. And I remember, I don't know if we did a discussion here, but I think we did, on why our fire trucks are white. Did that ever come into this room when we discussed or tried to enlighten you on that at all? Because I couldn't find out. I asked every member of the fire department that I know that had gone way back, from Chief Knowles to further back, well, Chief Ron Brown, three chiefs ago, finally gave you the information. Kevin actually found it and got it from him. The reason why they went to white was, and only one reason, to be different. Get away from the non-traditional stuff, so they went to white. Because they had all red fire trucks here back in the early 80s, and they spent money to paint them white.
Okay.
So, with that being said, the new fire truck is not going to be white anymore.
I'm okay with that.
You're bucking the system.
I am. I am bucking the system, kind of a little more of a traditionalist in that regard. But it's also a safety issue. There was numerous times this past winter where we were out on call during some of those 2-foot snowstorms that we had, those 3 in a row, 16, 18 inches, where engine 3 was coming back from calls and we're trying to park it on the ramp. You know, every single red light and light on, you could still could hardly see the fire truck, almost from beating you. So I'm like, how is that going to work when we're out in the middle of Route 4 trying to control an incident and you can't even see it? So that's one of the reasons why I wanted to switch over. And then, like I said, the other part being the traditionalist thing. Kind of, you know. So we were discussing it, and we've done a lot of work with it, and we were looking at a red over white scheme. And one thing is the new engine is going to have what's called roll-up doors. Instead of doors that open on a canopy, they're just going to roll up. So it gives you more space and depth to put the equipment that you need. And in order to save a little bit of money, we weren't going to paint those doors. So they come primer gray type color,
okay,
which is fine, and that's typically what we do. So we're going to do red over white, no, white over red, white on the top, red on the bottom. So we started thinking of doing some research, and Deputy Chief Glidden did some work, and so did some of the other members, and we came up with a little bit different scheme, and I kind of just wanted to show it to you. So if anybody says anything, or if you see anything, or even if you said, I don't like that, this is typically where we're going to head now, that kind of scheme.
Okay.
A gray over a red. That stripe that shows black will be white. It'll still be white on board. It'll be more of a hockey stick design. So that's where we're headed. It's not 100% cast in stone, but that's probably where we're going to head.
Okay.
I just wanted you guys to be aware of that, that's something, it wasn't solely something that I decided, it was a department.
The question that everyone's going to ask me, or ask anyone else on the board, is how much additional cost is it to have that?
About $300.
Okay.
Of which is nothing going to change from the prices that we've been talking about already. Do you see that?
But when we go to every vehicle, we have to add $300 before we pay. Not that it'll be next time we buy something, it'll be in our 80s.
Yeah, next time you go buy something, it won't be $450, it'll be $600,000,
right.
So you can squeeze it in under that for the time engine one needs to be replaced.
I love the positivity that you bring to the conversation.
So the gray, how does that show up with the snow?
Much better. And the thing is that's also has a metallic image to it, so it's a little
bit more reflective.
Yes.
So the vast majority of the truck is red. It's just
a tiny
portion of the top.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. And then, like I said, the roll up doors, and that's kind of all ties it in. We'll actually, before we get further down the road, because why I showed you that picture was because they're going to, we have some paint chips, and it's going to get sent out to the manufacturer, and they're actually going to paint a large portion and bring it back. So we have them. Instead of a little paint chip that everybody tries to look at something like that and make a decision,
right,
we're going to have a fairly large size to make our final decisions. Oh, what if we want to ski? But other than that, all the final specs are done. The truck is within 2 weeks of them starting to buy chassis and engine components and start putting it together. So that's moving forward.
Okay.
And the other question that I have, and I know we discussed it before, and I see Suzanne is not here, but it was on the command vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
And I have have some information on that, and I was kind of looking for some direction on what we wanted to do. We've done our due diligence of looking for local vendors. And by the list that we have here, this is all the government grant, state grant stuff.
Yeah.
The pricing, and there's a vehicle which we've been looking at is available at Hilltop Chevrolet.
Okay.
Which is, you know, Reynolds Vans right there on the road. And Kevin's gonna go up tomorrow and talk to the guy. There's a whole series of paperwork and hoops to dump through with these kind of things also. So we're starting that process, but I just wanted to make sure I wasn't putting the cart before the horse.
Maybe, because we were.
I know you'll wait till there was some money.
Yeah.
From flow or that way.
Wanna make sure that we're not an issue with that.
We're not going up there to sign a contract. We're not going up there to, you know, expend any funds at this time. It's more to make the first contact with the vendor so that we can take care of what paperwork's on his side.
Okay.
And then, because we can start the process, and it's still like a 90-day out process before you can get any vehicles. So if we were to do something, we wouldn't see anything, and it's almost time the fire truck's gonna arrive. But I did not want to, again, I don't wanna wait too long, try to start the process, so I was just kinda, I think it was between the three of you when you were all here, is I think it was, why don't we wait more towards summer?
Summer's arrived, or almost.
Almost.
Almost. But I would suggest that.
I think you had said wait maybe the first round of tax bills come back or something, yes.
And that won't be until.
That's in June.
June.
July.
I was gonna suggest you might wanna wait, come back and have this conversation at our first meeting in June.
Right, yeah, no, that's fine.
July.
Yeah, no.
The second week in June.
Okay.
Would be better, I think.
Okay, that's fine. That's why I just wanted to.
Just to be safe.
I wanted to just know where we were. Kevin is still gonna go have this conversation with them tomorrow.
Okay.
So we can at least.
I don't think it's a problem having a conversation, but I would worry about.
No purchase orders, nothing, no orders, nothing like that.
Making any sort of commitments at all.
No commitment. This is more just starting the process.
Okay.
And I just wanted you to make sure you were aware of that case, for whatever reason, somebody knows, just want something from Hilltop Chevrolet, call them back and say, what's that about? At least you would know that we will be making contact and at least find out what our procedure has to be then.
Okay. You all know that?
Yeah.
Alrighty. Anything else for us?
That's all I have.
I think we have anything.
Do you have anything for me?
I don't think so.
Joey, did you see my?
Oh, we do have something for you, actually, yes, we do.
Yes, you're.
There's two things, so.
The CPR classes?
Yes.
We're gonna look into that. What, I didn't know what was best for you guys. Is Monday better for you guys? Because that's your training day.
But that's fine.
Oh.
If anything else, if people wanted to come in and do it, we would have more individuals who'd help assist in the training.
Oh.
And sometimes it's better to have more people available because you can help almost a one-on-one kind of thing to make sure that people have the proper skills.
Okay, and then.
Sean Glidden is usually the guy that I run all this through.
Okay.
He's been gone last week and he's gone this week in California doing training for his new position. So the other thing that we can utilize, and since I have one of our individuals, is that Andy can provide some of this that too.
Okay.
So. If those are the two dates you're looking for, I know it's a Thursday and a Friday.
Well, we only pick those because that's right before when the rec started.
Once it gets going.
So we can do can we do the 12th and the 19th, or the 5th and the 12th, or any of those? So.
I'll find out. I can't commit to anything right now. But you want, what level, I mean, you want CPR?
Just CPR first aid, just for counselors. So.
Because there's different levels of health provider, there's
yeah,
all kinds of different
that.
Things that you can get. So you just want that, and then some first aid, you said also.
Right.
Like basic first aid class?
Yeah.
Okay.
And now I know my CPR original was like over 8 hours, and this shouldn't
yeah.
be, right? We're looking
no,
at like 4 hours.
Put, you could probably squeeze it into that size
okay.
of class, that
right.
time frame.
Sure. Right now we have 6 people right now that need it.
These are all like the council, those people are going to work at summer rec, so I won't put a turn to there.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then the building also needs it as well.
Town
so
employees?
If they're available that day, those days too.
Okay.
So
let me
iron
that down a little bit more. Yeah.
Okay.
And we'll try to get that coordinated for you.
Okay. And is it okay with the ice rink being back where it is?
Yeah.
The skating rink thing, okay.
It is, because, I don't know, a few Mondays ago, we took that apart, and that's, you know, it was, again, Sean's, a lot of his doing, we were doing that this year. And he asked me, it was fine, I go, I don't have an issue with it sitting right there.
Okay, great.
Because I wanted to use that cement pad, I think, the year before that, they had up against the building.
Mm-hmm.
But that was on the grass area, and, you know, critters and stuff decided they wanted to make that their home.
Right.
And there's a little less of that with it sitting on it, and it doesn't affect us in anything, out back, so it's fine.
Okay.
Well, that covers that, and there's also email notification from DES regarding Class B foam, you know, does that mean anything to you?
Yes, it does.
Okay. Have that covered, though?
Yeah, I just enlightened, what that is anytime we use foam.
Yeah.
For any incident, we need to document it and notify DES, because there's some research going on, that particular types of foam are hazardous to the environment.
Okay.
And most fire departments will use foam on a regular basis, whether it be a car fire, sometimes on building fires, to make sure it's completely suppressed, wild, you know, wildland fires, so now if you are, they wanna know where, what, when, how, and, so I know.
You have that under control?
Yeah.
Got that covered, perfect. Anything else, Chief?
No.
All right, thank you, and congratulations again, Kalen, thank you for your service.
Okay, good evening.
We will move into town administration. First item we have on here, is town hall available for nonprofit group, is that yours?
Oh, that was, and they meant somewhere else.
We're scratching that, I mean, do we wanna discuss it, or?
It was just the softball league, that needed, the board members wanted to put it to me for a night.
Oh, was it that night?
Yeah, so.
Okay.
Just in case it happens again, do we care?
So, you know, well, if you wanna, okay, let me do this. We have a library trustee here, I'm gonna ask her a question, if she doesn't mind answering. Do you have a written policy down there?
Yes.
Okay, could you send that to us?
Sure.
Okay, because it might help us determine whether or not, because there's all the things we need to think about, who's gonna open the building, cleaning up, that sort of thing. So if we wanna do it, I mean, I'm not opposed to whether nonprofit groups use the building, it's just we don't have a policy on it.
Right.
We know Suzanne's gonna say, what's the written policy, so.
Right.
Can you?
I'm sure.
Yeah, and I can just briefly tell you that there's the new community room in the back of the library too, that has enough space for a larger meeting than you'd be able to have here.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know if parents come, or if it's the type of thing where you'd have parents, and it's just for the board.
Yeah.
But, yeah, and the library, pretty much any night of the week. You just walk up when you're done.
Except for Thursdays, because yoga's done Thursday. Right, isn't it?
Yoga's in the big room on Thursday, but the rest of the library is empty.
It was smaller.
Oh, that's true.
Is that what we wanna still consider having, if people wanna meet here, do we wanna keep working on this, or we can scratch off the list?
We can scratch off this, we can.
All right, well, thank you.
Because I told them they could meet up for work.
All right.
We have plenty of them there too.
Review of legal priorities, we're gonna table that till Suzanne gets back, she wanted us to, and I'm happy to comply with that, unless you wanted to talk about it. Drainage contract, I believe, we deal with it right now, it's in the folder. Mr., I don't remember what his name was, but Ray Gagnon's son, I can't remember what it could be Ray as well, but came in, Norm, rather, came in today to drop some stuff off there. Still believing that they will be able to have everything ready to go by completion by the 30th of June, so.
Now, how are they gonna do their work while the roof is?
We had that conversation as well.
Okay.
They'll start the work that they can do now in the back, and we're hoping, well, it's gonna rain most of the week, so we'll see. They believe they can manage it, so there's enough work, I guess, they can do, so. But they understand that they are here. No, not at all. Scratch one thing off our list tonight.
Sure.
All right.
Got it, okay.
5:22, yep. Awesome, all right, so, it's executed and they will get started this week. Dog waste downtown, I stopped in to see the, were you here when we talked about this, I don't remember.
Probably.
Village vet has offered to give some signs. I stopped in last Thursday or Friday, there's two vets. Dr. Mike is the one who I had the conversation with, he wasn't in. The other vet, I wouldn't have known what I was talking about, so I was gonna go in today and didn't make it, so that's on me to talk to him again. I'll try again this week. Culvert project, so the easements are all completed. It just needs to be sent now over to legal for review. So we're good to go there. Town hall drainage, which is on here twice. We just did that, executed the contract, so that's good. Transfer station, Jeff is waiting on, this is my notes on it. Is awaiting the second bid still. We reached out again last week, and so we're still waiting on that. He gave us an update on working with Pike to deal with the retaining wall. Copying and scanning, I believe there is some info.
There is a info, but I think we might have to hold off on that for budgetary reasons. So we may have to pull from other funds because the rec numbers are not lining up right now. So we budgeted 100 kids and we have 51. So
we're gonna table copying and scanning them?
I would like to table, I can get this, but I don't wanna put anything in writing until summer's over.
We got it. It's a good deal though.
More kids saw that.
From what I saw, so. Okay, but so there's an offer on the table from the same company that's doing the police department. It seems pretty good actually.
Yes.
If we can make it work. All right. So we'll table. New Hope housing tax exemption. We're still waiting on Avatar. Caroline reached out again today. We heard back from Avatar. Avatar said they needed some other form, so they're reaching out again to New Hope Housing to get that form. So we're still waiting on Avatar, so we'll table, but that's where we stand at the moment. ADA coordinator, see email. Well, the Governor's Commission on Disabilities has sent us, every community in the state, a letter or / email notifying us that we need an ADA coordinator. It would seem that the best person to handle that probably the building inspector, seeing that he works on all those issues. We can forward the email on to Mr. Clark and see if that's something he believes he has time for. I don't know what the how intense the duties are. Let me see if I can find the email here. I'm gonna read it real quick. This could be something that actually requires some time, or it could just be you have to have someone. There it is. Good morning, the New Hampshire Governor's Commission on Disability needs to know who the ADA coordinator is for your town. It's not just to us, it's to a number of communities. Federal law states that a public entity that employs 50 or more persons, that's not us, so designate at least one employee to be an ADA coordinator. Please provide us with that name. Okay, so I think we would let Mr. Conley know from the Governor's Commission that we don't employ 50 people. So we would probably not have to have an ADA coordinator. Probably a moot point.
Agreed.
All right. Caroline just forwarded the email this afternoon and I haven't had a chance to read it. So it says read the email, and I did. So we would probably let them know that we don't need one. We don't have 50 employees. That was an easy one, though.
Will you send that to me, Mike?
I'll forward it to you right now. That may be the easiest thing to do all night. Nobody on the table. Okay, rec committee. I'll let you take that one.
We met last night.
Mm-hmm.
We're meeting again in 2 weeks and probably every night from there on in, because now it's getting close to the wire. I have in here to hire Andrew Gray as our camp director. Came with glowing recommendations. He's a football coach to Farmington, teaches special ed at Rochester. Pretty excited to have him on board. So he's very excited to have he's used to the Rochester rec with 300 children. So he was pretty excited to hear with a small number. He's ready to send them to boot camp and start football training. No, I'm kidding. No. So so we're pretty excited to have him on board, so.
Okay.
How was his name spelled?
G-R-A-Y.
Andrew Gray, just as.
G-R-A-Y.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, someone who was.
Okay, so we're going to, it's a full-time, 40-hour-per-week position?
Correct.
Okay. But it's only, somewhat temporary. So, we pay at the rate of $13 per hour. The camp will operate Monday through Friday with the exception of July 3rd and 4th, makes sense. Starting the week of June 26th for 8 consecutive weeks until August 18th. Perfect. All right. Now, we, we're the hiring entity, right, the select board? So, do you want to make a motion then, and I'll?
Motion to accept, Andrew Gray accepted our proposal for Summers Worth, Rollins counselor for Camp Raleigh for $13 an hour for the summer of 2017.
So, the motion is to offer the summer, the summer rec directorship to Andrew Gray?
Yeah.
For the amount of $13 an hour for 8 weeks, for 40 hours a week, I'll second. Okay.
Sorry.
No, that's okay, I just want to make sure that, I know what you're saying, but I want to make sure that, somebody got it. Okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye, opposed, I don't, it's us.
Yes, sorry.
Sign some separation, we can have that, for once. All right, anything else for rec? What did you say, you have 51 kids, you're hoping for 100?
We have 51 kids, we budgeted for about 100, 110.
Exactly.
It's an even number of kids, though, it's 19 in the first through third grade, 14 in another group, and 13 in another group or something, it's very evenly numbered.
19 in first through third, and then, 4, 5 is, 14.
Yeah.
And then 11, 6 through 8 graders. And the difference between male and females is 2 or 3. There's something like 21 males and 23 females, or something like that, it's very close.
It's a good mix, good.
And, so, there's a good mix of counselors, too.
Yeah, we have 5, 4 above the age of 18, and 2 below. We have 6 total right now, so.
Terrific.
Because we asked for 51% ratio.
All right, anything else for summer rec, or rec in general, sorry? We've got the.
No, summer is taking over rec for right now, but.
Perfect, all right.
We did talk about.
You did winter, too, you did the pool, so you covered, you had to take care of the place, so.
So, we did talk about, dog waste downtown, and if they wanted to take that on. We decided we will discuss that after summer.
I can appreciate that. There are more pressing issues for you guys, I get that completely. All right, so, if nothing else, we'll move on. J, select board assistance Thursdays through July, there was an email that went out yesterday or today, I saw. Saying the town hall was gonna be closed on, the select board office would be closed on Thursdays. So I asked, it's actually not, it wasn't actually accurate. She'll be here during the day, instead of at night.
She'll be here alone?
Yes, the building won't be open, she's still working, so she's still working her 32 hours.
Oh.
She's, has another, course that she's taking, on Thursday evenings, that we've discussed.
Oh.
Previously as a board, so.
Yes.
It's just starting now, so she, this is when it's happening, so. So, anyone, everyone knows that she's actually is working, not taking Thursdays off through the summer, so. All right, so hydro sale of, or of lease? Doesn't seem to make sense to me. There was a letter last week, Jody, that we received, that we want to refer to legal, but I thought we'd want to wait till you got here. The, transfers, the E&L, who operates transfer station, is being bought out.
I saw that.
So, we want to make sure there's no, any kind of implications for us. You know, we hold the license, but they're our operator, as we're going through the licensure, so we want to just make, to refer this to legal, so.
And the new company's gonna take over the relicensing process?
I hope so, so. So, okay. You got any sticky over there, by any chance? Perfect. All right. And historical committee, non-lapsing account, historical committee has not met about that, well. Although the auditor was in talking about something else, so the question came up as to what to do about that sort of issue. And he suggested, Mr. Dumas, Dumais rather, suggested that the best thing to do is to set up a non-lapsing fund through via town meeting, like we do for other things. That way, there's the proper accounting, so I will bring that information back to historical committee next time we meet. So, that's that. Kennebunk closing schedule, do we want to wait for Suzanne? She had suggested before she left that it could, that there was no issue waiting the couple weeks till she got back. If you're comfortable with that, or we can move forward with her if you want.
I'm fine to move forward, but I assume she would like to be here, so.
I'm okay with that if you want.
Yeah.
You gotta take it, that's fine. I didn't wanna hold it up if we didn't need to, but if she wants to wait, I'm happy to wait. What do we got here? Policies and procedures, welfare, that's
I didn't see anything before.
Okay, so we're not, there's nothing to discuss tonight, right?
No.
Okay, so we'll table that. All right, I'm sorry, I'm missing a note there, I'll put it on the board. Town administration, board member activities and updates. And do you have
I was just at a meeting last night, and I'll be one next week.
And you're meeting again next week, you said, is that coming Sunday?
I believe so, not next week, the week after.
Oh, wow, okay.
But somewhere from Memorial Day.
Yes.
You've had, made great progress?
So the four.
Director now?
Yes.
That's great.
They're doing great.
So the police space needs committee met last Thursday, and we did a tour of the three proposed sites that we talked about during our strategic planning meeting. The Silver Street location where the old highway shed is, the Rollins Road where the Porter store was a number of years ago, across from Greenview Drive,
yeah.
And the Turcotte Field. We took a hike out there. And the general consensus was that the Turcotte Field, although as lovely as it is truly a lovely space, it's not really the best option,
right,
considering how much road you have to put in to get there. There's still some interest, though, in the old Porter store location. I was asked to get some information about, you know, the cost, the size, all that. So I've got that information to bring back to the committee. It's $129,000 for 3.85 acres. So we can certainly have a conversation about that. There are some wet spots, but
that's what I
said. You know, anyways. And then the Silver Street, the chief sent out his survey to neighbors on Silver Street. I think it's all the way down to Cricket Lane and then up, and all of Silver Lane. So we'll see what people think about having it located there when they answer their surveys. It's the size of the building was staked out, so we could sort of get an idea, and it's my humble opinion, there's plenty of room there for that. Now, is there enough room to do expansion? Maybe, maybe not. So there was some conversation about would it make sense to just do it all at once, because you wouldn't. It wouldn't be practical to put a second or a third floor on once it's been built. Could the type of design that we're looking at. Although we haven't finalized that yet either, but it was a good meeting. A lot of good questions. We're gonna meet again on the 15th, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, here on the 15th, so.
May
15th?
No.
June 15th. They say, we're not going back in time.
Yeah.
Not for that. And the planning board has a number of issues coming before the first week in June, but we won't be meeting before that, so I'll tell you about them now. There's one, actually there's only one, one's going to the ZBA first, so. But there are two proposed self-storage facilities here in town. One off of Greenview Drive, which is industrial, commercial. Seems to make a little more sense. And then there's one proposed off of Oak Street that would need to go to the ZBA first to get a waiver. And we're not saying anything about that because it hasn't happened, so. But that will be happening the first week. The ZBA is meeting, I think, May 25th, when they're supposed to. Let's see if that actually happens. And that's what happened in my world anyways. And if there's no other updates, we're gonna move on to building permits. And the first one I have is building permit 2017-048-426 Third Street. They're replacing their roof. Mr. Clark has reviewed it, $100 fee. Next one is 2017-05140 Jesse Doe Road. It's American Tower Corporation. Everyone says, on behalf of T-Mobile, the proposed work involves swapping out three antennas and replacing them with three new antennas. Mr. Clark has reviewed it. It's a $175 fee. Paperwork is here if you want to see it. This happens from time to time. It's not. I don't think it happened last year, but it happens not infrequently as well. We need your stamp too, but we have to do this one first. We have a certificate of occupancy for 649 through 655 Main Street. That would be the building directly to our left. It has been completely rehabbed. I actually had the opportunity to go in there and have a tour of it today. A gentleman is very eager for people to see it, actually. He and his wife both were there. To say it's an amazing transformation is really an understatement. I mean, it's just, it's absolutely gorgeous in there. They both really want to see the project succeed, but they also want to make sure that it's sort of a gem, and we thank them for it. And they're hoping to do more projects in town. And given the level of work they did in there, I hope they do find some properties to buy. We have one extra project that we're close.
That's okay. 41 Rollins Road. Septic design. great. I thought you guys.
Okay. Across the street.
Across the street.
Oh, okay.
I knew it was going to happen because the guy was there for a whole day.
Oh.
he brought in, there's only one cover sheet, but he'd like to stamp all three copies if you don't mind.
Everything in my cap. I'd rather be safe
as well. Right. Yes, he was in for quite a while when I was trying to sign bills today, explaining to us in great detail what they're going to do. To which I said, I just need the cover sheet. I don't review them personally, so. But he was very proud of the level of work they were doing.
Hmm.
More than septic?
No, it was just a very simple fix on the septic tank at the Rollins.
Okay.
There was some tree root issues, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
They have solved the issue apparently. But his card is there if you want to call him. He will explain it all to you if you want to hear it. He was very nice. Very nice.
contagious.
Definitely is.
Anything else here?
This is saying.
That's the stuff you.
I have two purchase orders here. Just for the sake of time, I'll just do them. The first is purchase order number 1274, made out to Digital Inc. It's for our yearly order of the window envelopes and town clerk report to treasurer books, the receipts that go back and forth to the treasurer and the clerk, for a grand total of $423.93.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed, all right. I will have envelopes. Next is the Northeast Records, purchase order number 1275, sorry. It's for the mobile shredding truck that comes, that we do yearly apparently. It says yearly purge of documents needing shredding for the police department, the town clerk, and the administrative office, for a grand total of $200.
Second.
All right, all those in favor? Aye, opposed?
Oh, aye.
You have to say something tonight, definitely. Whatever, we won't pass anything. All right. That's all that I have in this folder.
We have a letter to Mr. Ben, no.
Oh, yes, yeah. So, last week we received a letter to Mr. Brunel regarding his post there on Prospect Street. And we needed a little wordsmithing, so we did that. We also added, when he came before us, he had mentioned a police report. And so we mentioned during your last visit to the select board, that we referenced a police report filed regarding the damage to your post. Enclosed, please find a copy of that report, which does not indicate that the damage was done by the plow. We apologize for the frustration and inconvenience this has caused you. So, I probably just wrote a whole letter, sorry. This letter is a follow-up to your visit to the select board on May 8th. We understand that you believe the right-of-way on Prospect Street may have changed at some point. Unfortunately, we have no record of this at this time, at that time, this at the town office. You may indeed be correct. However, under such circumstances, the burden of proof is on the property owner. If you should find reference to a public town document or a letter which you may have received to that effect, which may prove what you believe, we will be happy to consider that. Until that time, we will consider the matter closed. And then I just read to you the other part. So if we're good, we'll send it off to them.
Please do.
I wanted to try to find something that said, until that time, we will consider the matter closed. We didn't really come up with anything nicer than that. So it seemed appropriate still, so. And we'll send an option to Mr. Burnham.
Okay. And we got a magazine from Great Bay Matters.
Oh, my God.
Purchase order for to V&B Printing for the newsletter. Purchase order 1212. V&B Printing for 1,200 copies of the newsletter for $199.
Second. Any discussion? I will say that I saw the advanced copy. It looked really good, actually. I know Mark Kutcher, or not Mark Kutcher, Ed Charpentier was very excited. I saw him on Sunday for the mention about his relatives that helped plant the tree down in the park. So.
It's okay.
Anyway, let's see it before we go. It looks really good. It looks the same as everybody's. So. All right, so all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye, those opposed, all right. All right, there's that. Well, thank you for doing that.
And a letter from DES.
I know, well, these two aren't I so lucky for coming in today.
Would
you? Yeah, you want to just talk about it and be quicker if you don't mind. So, you'll recall, this is a certified letter from the Department of Environmental Service. You'll recall a while back we received notice that we needed to file our transfer station slash recycling center report. It's still being compiled. This is a reminder that we still need to file it. There's no late fees or anything, penalties or anything like that. The thing that's holding them up is a form changed apparently, and it's a, some of the questions aren't as intuitive and as easy to find the answers to apparently as it was in the past for the way it's phrased, so they're parsing out some of that information, but Caroline is working with Jeff, I think Selma, you were helping too, she said.
Oh, yes.
So, you can.
I have no idea what they want.
Okay, well, it's being worked on, so, like I said, we've got it under control, but the state has sent us another letter saying we need to do this. They're working on it, so, but feel free to read through it, it's,
No.
Yeah, it's.
No.
We know we need to fix it, finish it.
Yes, the other things that are in here are previously from before, the Comcast and the roads that they're gonna be paving this summer when DOT comes through, so.
Perfect.
And that is it.
All right, do we have anything else we need to talk about?
That was it, no.
All right, I don't have anything else on my notes, so, community input.
Where's the 3.8-acre quarter store property?
On the corner of Rollins Road and Summersworth Road.
Near Pease Lane.
And Greenview, so it's not right on the corner, it's over that short.
Oh, the flat piece next to the barns.
Yes, used to be a convenience store there a long time ago. And gas pumps, right?
And how did the chief distribute the survey?
Via mail, actual mail, he mailed them either today.
Oh, okay.
He just bought the stamps, we gave him permission to buy the stamps tonight, so. I don't know if he actually bought them already today, or if he's buying them today, tomorrow probably, but they're going out.
Cause
You will be getting it.
I live orders down, so I just wanna know how.
You will definitely be getting it, it's going all the way down to Cricket Lane.
Great, thank you.
On your side, and obviously down to the overpass, the other way, and all the way down Silver Lane too.
And that's a state road?
Mm-hmm.
Would anything that we do impact our ability to have sidewalks on that street once the police station is there?
I don't think so. Cause we wouldn't be, very, very, very early stages of any kind of planning and conversations, but the building would be set back far enough where there wouldn't be, even the parking I don't think would still be plenty of space.
Well, I'm just curious about like, if that's gonna be part of the, you know, like we're gonna.
Well, the plan to put inside as part of the.
Move some community piece of something there, I mean, that street.
If we wanted to put sidewalks in there.
Death trap now.
It would be a much different conversation with DOT, yeah, it's not part of the, I shouldn't say that, we haven't devised a plan yet, but it has not been part of the conversation, putting in sidewalks there. But there may be something the chief suggests, that if we're putting the building there, does it make sense to? Cause there are some by the overpass, right, but they just end right there, they don't go any further down. I remember Harry Knowles' father, asking me for years to get sidewalks back there when I was in the legislature, I was like, Mr. Knowles, that's the Department of Transportation wouldn't do it because the town would have to pay for it. So it's not the first time.
All I'm asking is it possible for us to do it on a state road if we chose to? That's the question.
The answer is yes.
Okay, thank you.
That much I know. Is there a will or means? Perhaps not, but you can, yes, that much I know.
Okay.
Oh, look at you, I thought you had a question, like, oh, what am I doing? Sorry, Celia.
You had talked about expansion of the police station on the Silver Street lot, if you go there, and that the building you're looking at may not be feasible for upward growth, and that it would be maybe difficult to go outward. Is that something that you plan to talk to the committee about down the road? Like,
oh, yeah.
Maybe getting a building that's more feasible for growth upward or whatever?
Okay. Definitely.
Okay. And do you?
I mean, nothing has been decided. It's just this is.
No, we have 2 meetings.
We've only 2 meetings, right? And the one thing we've decided, I will tell you all, is that yeah, there will be more meetings, and that we will not meet the chief wanted a month long, everything done in a month. It's not going to be feasible, and he understands that. So
And.
That's the only thing that's been decided.
Do you take public comment at these meetings, or is it just like?
We will, I mean, we haven't yet, I mean.
Okay.
But as we get further down the road, of course, oh, most definitely.
Okay.
We haven't, there's nothing to really comment on yet, I mean, we haven't really presented anything.
I hear you getting input from, like, the people in the neighborhood where the most ideal locations would be, but.
Yeah.
That, like, I live now in the neighborhood where it currently is, and I don't wanna see it move too far, and I wanna be able to express my own thoughts.
I hear you.
And then, has the discussion come up of whether it's going to be joint town officials moving with it, or is it just going to be the police department?
Well, we were charged with dealing with the police aspect, I mean, that has creeped into the conversation, it's sort of natural. And it sort of did a little bit at our strategic planning meeting, to a certain degree. So we don't have any definite plans one way or another, I mean, there have been, there's a company out of Rochester that built the, the Growens, yeah, construction company that built the Farmington Police Station. So they have given us, some specs, they saw us out actually, when they saw an article in the paper. But we, I mean, there's no commitment to go with them, or even to go with that type of design. If you're asking one individual, it seems like a pretty good design, but, there's no decision to make yet. But if we were to go that route, there is a possibility of incorporating both going up. I mean, there's also a possibility of going up, depending on where you move to. The design that they've given us right now, if we didn't add on at the beginning phase, it wouldn't be economically, it wouldn't make much sense economically to put on a second or a third story afterwards because of the way it's framed, I mean, it wouldn't make any sense. You're much better off to do it at the beginning. But there's no, one, there's no consensus whether or not we wanna do that, or, and there's no design, so. But it's, as the ideas sort of get teased out and parsed out, I think it's a natural part of the conversation, at least, to talk about it, so. But no decisions at all have been made. But we did talk about it on site, you know, would it make sense to go up, or could you go out? And all those meetings are open to the public, so if you wanted to trample on Scotland Road in the mud with us to look at the turquoise field, you're welcome.
Unfortunately,
that I'm sorry. Well, no, I'm not sorry to say you should have been, I'm just saying, but if you want to come, I'm not gonna make you feel bad because you weren't there, I'm just saying, if you wanna come to any of those, they're always, every meeting is open to public, so.
I will try in future.
Even once we go on field trips, you're welcome.
A reminder that I know that both of, a few people in the room have ordered t-shirts, but the Camp Rona t-shirt orders closed this week, they will be in the week before Father's Day, and that has given a little extra money to the budget for the committee.
And I have said our checks were finally cashed. You and I had outstanding checks for t-shirts.
Oh, yes, yes. So.
I didn't even realize, I thought it had been, but it wasn't.
Scott does the book, so I have no idea. When he asked me, I'm like, I don't know.
Yeah, I got that update today. Anything else for the public? Going once, going twice, going three times.
Motion to adjourn.
By consensus, we shall adjourn at 8 o'clock.